You want a bite?
No, I'm okay.
Besides, I don't think that you really thought about everything that went into putting that hamburger onto your plate. Did you think about the carbon footprint left by that one hamburger?
This time on ContECHtual, we head over to a laboratory that's growing meat, and we get the scoop about this future food from the experts.
It's estimated that each quarter pound of burger meat counts for about 6.25 pounds of carbon dioxide emissions.
Per burger?
Yikes.
Yes, per burger. And the EPA estimated that cows produce more than 550,000 tons of methane per 2.2 billion pounds of hamburger meat. And that's about 0.126 pounds of methane per quarter pound of hamburger.
Okay, I get it. I shouldn't have ordered a cheeseburger.
No, you shouldn't have. And I don't know if you do get it, because we're not even talking about the water consumption, transportation.
I get it.
The raw numbers are staggering, Andrew. Millions of SUV emissions rolled into one product.
Dane,
it's crazy.
Dane, don't meat-splain to me, all right? I understand it all. I get it. It's just, I love cheeseburgers. Like, I don't think you get it. Like, so much. So what am I supposed to do?
It's gonna be okay. Come with me on a journey to the West Coast. Come with me. Come with me.
This
is your alternative to a cheeseburger.
This?
Yes.
I don't know. Is this gonna be a stand-in for a cheeseburger, an actual stand-in for a cheeseburger?
I had a very similar question, and that is why I invited Vitor along. Hello, Vitor.
Hi.
Why do we need clean meat?
Definitely, the sustainability is the key. Current meat production systems are not sustainable. Population numbers are increasing, and so is consumption of meat per capita. It's estimated by 2050, the consumption of meat will double.
See, I told you. Cheeseburger over here.
You're right, and I feel bad, so you're welcome.
I'm sort of picturing little cultures bubbling up and then forming a chicken breast. That's not really how it works, is it?
Or is it? Not really. Lab-grown meat or clean meat starts with isolating a small volume of cells at a biopsy without having to sacrifice the animal, and then you have to make the cells proliferate fast. And for that, you have to feed them with the nutrients, like the proteins, the sugars.
You're feeding plants to
exactly, mimicking what happens in nature. When you get the right formula, you're ready to scale up production. And for that, you use fermentation process that is very similar, imagine, for production of beer. It's just like these big bioreactors with large volumes, thousands of liters. And then separate the liquids and from the solid cell paste, give these cells to our team of chefs. They give us feedback in terms of taste, texture, and they are the first ones that cook the cells and make these products.
And what does that final product look like?
This is our chicken chorizo. Looks very similar to what we can find in the grocery stores. It's really tasty as well.
Oh, that's good. What I was gonna ask.
Yeah, very exciting.
Wow.
So
I'm holding meat that was grown in a lab.
Yeah, so meat in general is a mixture of muscle cells, fat cells, you can also add some blood cells. You can optimize the growth for each individual cell type, and then you can assemble everything together at different percentages. You can almost like do design, meat design, right? You want to create a meat product that is more enriched in fat, or you don't want a lot of fat. It depends on your goal.
It's like designer meat.
Yeah.
Growing cells sounds so sci-fi, and
I know.
Will we grow extra limbs or get superpowers from these?
No, it's definitely safe. We don't do any sort of manipulation to the cells. We're only selecting the ones that are growing faster. Everything happens in the lab. We're avoiding the possible contaminations that happen nowadays.
So you could just like take a bite out of a raw chicken breast if you grew it in a lab?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit, depends on your taste if you're into raw meat.
I have a question, and it's been burning in my mind. Premium meat, down the line, are we looking at like really prime cuts of beef, of chicken? My palate needs to know.
Yes, the beauty of the process is that you can work with premium types of meat, like Kobe beef, and it can be in a patty, it can be like a steak. So this can also make all these products that might be a little bit more of a niche product more affordable and available to everyone.
Oh God. You know, it feels like we've just been here.
I think we were, Andrew. You really like this diner.
Well, the specials are slamming.
So it's worth noting that just rebranded in 2017 from Hampton Creek after it was reported that they organized a buyout of their product from all major chains in order to seem a little bit more popular than they were.
Yeah, well, even more interesting is this.
Andrew, we just talked about this.
First of all, we're in public, okay? So dial that down to about a 5. Second of all, you said you would eat lab-grown meat, and that burger is lab-grown.
They serve lab-grown meat here?
I mean, sure. Wow.
It's actually really good.
Cool, you owe me $325,000. I'm joking. Creating lab-grown meat used to be a hundreds of thousands of dollars ordeal. Today, the process is way more refined, but it costs about $600 per pound of meat.
So this is a $300 hamburger?
Yes.
For me?
Yes. Enjoy it. Eat it. Don't tell Dane, but that burger isn't lab-grown. It's just a regular cheeseburger. Lab-grown meat just isn't there yet. The scientists are trying really, really hard to get it down to about $5 a pound of lab-grown meat, so give it time. Before you know it, there'll be lab-grown meat in the stores, and you and I can tell Dane then. See you guys next time. Hey, thanks so much for watching. We didn't get to show it in the episode, but we got to try some Just Brand scrambled eggs.
They were made from mung beans, and they were delicious.
Mung beans. Next time, I shrink down to demonstrate the power of carbon nanotubes.
To stay on top of new episodes, be sure to subscribe and to click the little bell button for notifications.
Please click.